John Cappelletti, the 45th anniversary of his Heisman Trophy.
On the Maxwell and Camp and Heisman list.
There's only so many opportunities you get. Come out, fight for your brothers, put on this blue and white. 1, 2, 3.
McSorley deep for Tompkins. He's got a touchdown. First and goal now. They can do it. McSorley waltzes in. Touchdown. McSorley leaps it again. Touchdown. And only one behind Penn State legends Franco Harris and Kurt Warner. McSorley decides to run it. It's wide open. It's touchdown. Well, that ties Franco and Kurt Warner for touchdowns rushing. Those are some heavyweights we're talking about. McSorley looping it long. It's touchdown.
This is Unrivaled, the Penn State football story presented by Pepsi.
Penn State, 19 straight wins against unranked foes, the third longest streak in the nation. Kent State in town today.
Celebrate the 45th anniversary of his Heisman Trophy and the undefeated 1973 team.
The last time Penn State had a home loss was back in 2015. They've rung up 15 straight.
Oh, boy.
With James Franklin, an 11th-ranked Penn State in-state college, as they look to continue their unbeaten start.
One of three teams really out of the Big Ten Conference with aspirations of the college football playoff.
McSorley is going to hold just about every Penn State quarterback record by the end of his senior campaign.
Yeah, blue shirt. We know what's about to go down.
You're a Penn State wide receiver. Like you said, you're the best in America. Believe it. Show it today. This is football. Helmets and shoulder pads. That's how this thing was invented. All day long, you punish these people.
Man, I'm ready for game day, man. It's another opportunity to go out there with my brothers, man, and get this done, man.
Everything goes through Trace McSorley. This kid's a winner. 33 victories, our touchdown passes that he's been able to do since he's been there. When you talk about an offense, it really starts with Trace. You can talk about the other parts, but everything starts at the quarterback position.
Hey, man, there's only so many opportunities you get. Come out, fight for your brothers, put on this blue and white. Make that special. Every time you step on this field, it's an opportunity. Take advantage of every single one, start to finish. Let's put on a show for everyone out here, man. Let's go, let's go. And dominate all three. 1, 2, 3.
Hey, listen up. We're at Beaver Stadium. Opponent has not outscored us in Beaver Stadium in 796 days. Woo. November 21st, 2015 was the last time an opponent actually scored more points than us. Nice. That will never happen today. Today is another day to keep on showing the world that when you come to Beaver Stadium, you're going down.
Are you ready for Penn State football?
I love you guys. And I appreciate you guys more than I could ever express. Don't let one play, don't let one opportunity slip by without ultimate focus and ultimate execution. Let's go do this. Go,
Trace McSorley, Koa Farmer, Nick Scott, Blake Gilligan up front with James Franklin.
There's nothing quite like it. Game day. At Penn State.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome home. Today's honorary captain, Penn State's only Heisman Trophy winner, John Cappelletti.
They are 700 tickets shy of a sellout today as they get ready for Kent State.
And here comes Trace McSorley. You name it, he's got it on the Maxwell and Camp and Heisman list. They go out of the shotgun on first down. Will swing pass out to Sanders. Of the backs, he's the one they like to utilize in that manner, and he's got a first down.
It's about miles and miles and miles.
Delivers over the middle. It's caught 45-yard line as they go to Pat Freiermuth, the freshman tight end.
No.
Deep for Tompkins. He's got it. Touchdown. DeAndre Tompkins.
I was waiting for it.
Guys in the box! Play the quarterback run! Dollar blue! Go get him! Three rushers! Go get him!
Ripped out right away by Torin Castro Field.
Stripped right away by Garrett Taylor.
This is the big league right here.
Second and 10, quarterback draw, and runs right into a bevy of Nittany Lions. They were waiting for him.
He's going to be wrapped up at the 35-yard line.
Guys flying to the football and gang tackling. Defense very disciplined.
He's going to be given to Sanders, 35-40, and dives in over the 40-yard line.
You talk about smoke through a keyhole. That looks nondescript. Let me tell you something, that's a big-time run.
McSorley, so resourceful. On second down, Sanders. Nice spin, spin, baby, spin. Down to the two.
That's just tremendous vision.
Fake it to him, McSorley waltzes in. Touchdown.
And now tied for 16th in Penn State history for rushing touchdowns.
They're coming up and playing
SBK.
We'll fight, keep going, that's it.
Love it. That's what I'm talking about. Fourth down and one at the two.
McSorley leaps it again, touchdown. He's tied now, Franco and Kurt Warner. That's both big. Who've had 24 career touchdown runs. Barrett in trouble. Down he goes. We've had a lot of those. Third down, sacks. Gross Matos. Third down and goal.
Crowd's alive here at Beaver Stadium. Incomplete. Ripped down by Amani Oriwariye. We'll have to settle for three. With 35 seconds to go, if Hamler gets his hands on the ball, he can bring it past the 35.
Here is Hamler from his five.
Nice.
KJ trying to make them pay. Hamler time at Penn State. Out pattern. Hamler has it right where you want it.
That's a big time throw right there.
With 9 seconds to go in the half.
McSorley decides to run. It's wide open. It's touchdown.
Again, that extra option in Trace McSorley.
Nice eyes, nice read, ball security. McSorley just said, let me score.
Well, that ties Franco and Kurt Warner for touchdowns rushing. Those are some heavyweights we're talking about. Total team effort with that kind of talent. And tying a career high for him in a single game. Well, that's the story here at the break. Penn State, the late scorer in Happy Valley.
Match the tempo. Don't be surprised by it. We got to handle the tempo. They're going as fast as they can. Right now, they can't block our D-line. They can't block you guys.
We got to come. We got to be cleaner. We got to be crispy. Let's go.
Hey, let's have a clean second half, and let's dominate you. Bury them. Every single snap, bury them a little bit more. Dominate start to finish. Play clean. One play at a time. Let's go. Awesome.
Oh.
corner. That's the tight end, Freiermuth. They think this kid is going to be really special. Allen, touchdown!
Talk to all the running backs. We got to consistently get the ball to our outside arm, because that's going to allow us to break some of those tackles. And I'm not really you, I'm talking everybody.
Nut and drop, there's Cam Brown.
In the arms of Sharif Miller, who's been everywhere today. Great field position to open for McSorley.
And a first and goal for the Nittany Lions at the 2-yard line.
There goes Ricky Slade. First carry, first touchdown of the day.
Strong safety position again. You're going to see it, but hear it better. Oof.
Popping out is McSorley again. He sees the sticks and goes right for that. 9 rushes, 54 yards. McSorley toward the sidelines, and he's got his man. That's Polk.
That's a big time throw across the field on the deep out. That's a next level throw there.
McSorley looping it long. It's nice. Caught. Touchdown. Brandon Polk, 41 yards.
This is just showing off the speed right now to Penn State wide receivers.
And another sack. And Jason Owe is the man that came through to get some help. Sacked again. They're coming from everywhere now. Owe again. Hamler looking for a picket fence. Negotiates. Navigates. Now he has a convoy.
John Clifford takes over quarterback.
A long one to Daniel George.
Wide open, got it to 40. 50, 40, George to the 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown. Daniel George, his first career catch, and he ends up going all the way for a touchdown.
Jonathan Thomas, touchdown.
Game, and we are, but we can be better. It always starts with I love you.
It always ends with I love you.
Bam, on three, 1, 2, 3.
Bam!
This week on campus in Penn State Athletics, Penn State's field hockey team will host Michigan Friday night at the Penn State Field Hockey Complex starting at 6. The women's golf team will host the Nittany Lion Invitational Saturday and Sunday at the Blue Course beginning at 8 a.m. each day. The women's hockey team will host Ryerson at 1 o'clock Saturday at Pagoula Ice Arena. On Sunday, the field hockey team will host Michigan State at noon at the Penn State Field Hockey Complex. And Wednesday, the men's soccer team hosts Michigan State at 6 o'clock at Jeffrey Field. That's this week on campus in Penn State Athletics.
There is an old saying, you either get better or you get worse. You never stay the same. In the pool this year, Penn State's Allie McHugh didn't just get better. She became a force on the national scene.
Amazing would definitely be the word I use to describe it. It was definitely a little bit of a shock to make
the Pan Pac team in the event that I did. I love the IM. I've always loved it. Distance freestyle has kind of been my focus for these past 2 years, so I think the IM's kind of been on the back burner a little bit. I was just really excited to make a team in that event because I really do love it.
It has been a combination of hard work leading to great confidence.
Big Ten's definitely, I think, set it up for the rest of the year and leading into the summer. I just was so shocked that I got the Big Ten record and that I had won and that I had dropped so much time in that event also. I like watched that video a million times of me finishing that race at Big Ten's because like just seeing my face and then they show the team on the side just completely going nuts, an amazing moment.
NBC Sports Olympic swimming analyst Rowdy Gaines was incredibly impressed by McHugh's work at Irvine, California last July.
I mean, it was unbelievable to see. She wins the 400 IM, which there is nobody in the building or nobody in that arena that said she was going to win that race. And she did it, and she did it in a time that was, you know, the third fastest time in the world at the time. So one of those meets that you just dream about as an athlete. I think one of the big things is you know, her coach Tim Murphy at Penn State, they have instilled a confidence in all of their athletes, but certainly Allie.
Athletic Director Sandy Barber knows McHugh is making the most of her experience at Penn State.
To watch Allie do what she did at the U.S. Championships this year and then ultimately at the Worlds, it just speaks volumes about Allie as a person. It speaks volumes about our program.
Allie doesn't just spend every second in the pool. She gets into other sporting events on campus, from Beaver Stadium to being in the front row for the Legion of Blue at the Jordan Center.
Part of the college experience is experiencing everything. Going to other sporting events and participating in other student sections and also getting to know other athletes on other sports teams and what their practice schedule and what their training looks like.
Family has influenced her career decisions.
My mom is a nurse, so I've kind of grown up knowing the field, but I just can't see myself not helping people or constantly doing something and just helping people get better and focusing on their health.
As for the upcoming year,
we haven't seen the best of Allie McHugh yet. You know, what she did this summer puts her on the right path to make a whole lot of noise in 2020 in Tokyo.
Allie McHugh, a Penn State champion on the international scene.
Hold up.
Yeah, there you go. Loosen up. Get limber. Gotta get limber for this, though, man. Yeah. Big tire.
Unrivaled, the Penn State football story presented by Pepsi. This is the Pepsi for those who are forever fun. This is the Pepsi for every generation. Pepsi, proud partner of Penn State Nittany Lion football. Also brought to you in part by PSECU. We are banking on a difference.
Big Ten play will be Big Ten play. It's just every game to us, and that's how we approach it. This week we got Illinois. We want to focus on ourselves in practice, continue to work hard.
You know, you got to bring your A game all the time. There's no team that you can overlook. There's no team that's too good for you. There's no team that's below you. You always have to approach each game the same, as if it's your Super Bowl. And if you're able to do that on a consistent basis and give everybody the respect that they deserve in this league, you have a good chance of being competitive.
The biggest factor in this game, no doubt about it, is going to be turnovers. They have not turned the ball over this year, one of only a few programs in the country that has done that, and they've gotten multiple turnovers in almost every game, you know, this season. So that's going to be the storyline in the game.
In football, it's making this guy that you're going against uncomfortable for 60 minutes. They'll break at some point. They're going to give into it. They're going to give in to it at some point when you keep pounding them play after play. So understand the value at every position of making your opponent uncomfortable for four quarters. And that's why we train ourselves this way every single day of practice.
Here we go. We'll get started, men. All right, let's make sure, like Coach said, let's continue to work to be early to meetings. Our general notes for the day, our practice priority, focus, and attention to details. All right, we learned the game plan yesterday, had a chance to get that installed. It is going to be warm there Friday night. So let's make sure that we're working on our hydration, our rest all week, and not just waiting till game day to drink right stuff right before the game. Everything you do revolving around being an O-lineman, let's take a great deal of pride in it. Let's work every day to become physically dominant, all right, and relentless finishers. That's our goal. We're taking this thing to a new standard. Be prepared to have a great day. Everybody understand? All right, good. Let's have a great one, man.
I'm feeling good, man. Just another day to go out and get better. Get ready for Illinois. Big Friday night game. Looking good for practice this week. Gotta love it. Every day, getting better.
Let's go.
Gotta out-invest these guys. That's what it comes down to. Hey, we all got that same 24 hours to work with. It's how bad and how you utilize yours. That's what it's gonna come down to. So don't waste the rep tonight, right? Getting the sleep, getting the hydration, spending your film. Everybody good?
Sure.
All right, man, get to work.
Here we go.
Where is Daniel George?
Today your birthday? Hey, birthday boy, break us down.
Proper handshake.
Break us down, Eric.
Family on three, 1, 2, 3.
Family.